Filtering is a great feature of Excel that gives you a lot of control over which parts of your spreadsheet are displayed. It's a little bit like outlining and grouping, but it's even more powerful, and it actually makes it a little bit easier to narrow down your data in different ways. Now, it's important that you have a header row because the filters actually get added to the cells in the header row. In this example, I have an equipment checkout log, and there are a lot of things to keep track of, so I'd like to use some filters to simplify it. First, go to the Data tab and click the Filter command. You'll see these drop-down arrows added to your header row, and you'll use these to access all of the filtering options. Here, you'll see a list of all of the different values that appear in this column. I'd like to just view the laptops and projectors, so I'll leave those checked and uncheck everything else. And then click OK. And now the drop-down arrow has changed to a different icon to show that there is a filter in this column. We can narrow down this data even further by adding a filter to another column. Let's filter by the date that the items were checked out. This shows all of the months that appear in this column, so I'll uncheck the months that I don't want. You can also click the plus sign next to the month if you want to filter by the specific dates. And then click OK. To get rid of the filter, just click on the icon and select Clear Filter. So that's how you do simple filtering. Now let's look at some more advanced techniques. When you click the drop-down box, you can actually search for values that appear in this column. In this example, a lot of our equipment is made by a company called Ceres, so if we type that, then the list below it will only display those items. And then click OK. Now, let's say that I only want to show items where the ID number is between 3,000 and 4,000. I can click on the drop-down box for this column and go to Number Filters. There are a lot of different options here, and I'll click on Between. Now I can type in whatever values I want here. So this will show rows that are greater than or equal to 3,000 and less than or equal to 4,000. And now you can see that all of these values are between 3,000 and 4,000. And I'm just going to clear these filters. Now the date filters are really cool because they can use the current date to filter data. I'd like to find out which items were checked out this week. If we go to the date filters, we have many different options, and I'll select this week. Finally, if you'd like to clear all of the filters and get rid of these drop-down arrows, you can just click the filter command again, and your spreadsheet will go back to showing everything. So you can see how quickly filtering can narrow things down, and it gives you so many different options, you can probably find a use for it with any spreadsheet.
Like what you just saw? Rate it.
Add a comment.
Subscribe to our channel.
The freedom to learn.
What you want, when you want.
Absolutely free.
GCFLearnFree.org.